My name is Varshali Bhattacharya. I am Deputy Director of Industry Research at the Economist Intelligence Unit. And today, I want to take a look ahead at the economic outlook for the US in the second half of 2024 and discuss some key themes for professional services businesses to watch. Let's start off with inflation, which is on top of everyone's minds, consumers, businesses, and policymakers. Prices have been quite stubborn on the back of stronger than expected domestic growth in the US, but there is some good news finally. We expect disinflation to continue throughout 2024. We expect consumer inflation to slow down to 2.8% in the last quarter of 2024. For the full year, we expect it to average at 3%. That compares with about 4.1% in 2023. Now, what does this mean for the Fed's policy? Early rate cuts are probably off the table now. We expect a wait and watch approach until at least September, with two rather than three rate cuts likely to happen through the rest of the year. There are some interesting trends to watch in the labor market. High inflation and interest rates are putting pressure on businesses, which is showing up as a slight increase in unemployment. The jobs data for May shows unemployment rising up to 4%. Now, this isn't necessarily bad news. A slight cooling of the labor market can actually help manage inflation and pave the way for the Fed to cut interest rates, potentially achieving a soft landing. Looking at job sectors, the US healthcare sector has shown some strong growth, driven by an aging population and a lower doctor-to-patient ratio than the OECD average. This will be a sector to watch for recruitment agencies, with companies offering bonuses and incentives to attract the right talent. Beyond healthcare, leisure and hospitality, transport and warehousing have also shown growth in recent months. And there is an interesting trend to watch here. While growth in white-collar jobs, especially in the knowledge sector, has been slowing, blue-collar jobs, those requiring physical skills and dexterity, have actually been doing much better. Now, these include roles in retail, warehousing, nursing, and hospitality. Even within the retail sector, where a lot of layoffs have recently been announced, most of these have been targeted at office workers rather than in-store employees. Looking at other professional services companies, the macroeconomic conditions present challenges, but there are some silver linings. One challenge worth noticing is the strong US dollar, which has been boosted by high interest rates. Now, we expect the US dollar to retain its strength through most of 2024 until at least the Fed starts cutting interest rates. For US professional services companies, most of which have global operations, this could wipe out some of their international earnings when repatriated. Now, this could also make them more expensive and potentially less competitive in international markets. But there are opportunities elsewhere. Deal making is picking up this year after a slow 2023. And this is great news for consultancies. We are once again seeing corporate M&As make headlines as many strong businesses use the current economic slowdown to get ahead of competitors and consolidate their market position. In recent past, there has been news of Home Depot's acquisition of SRS, Nvidia snapping up AI startups, and the Tapestry-Capri merger. Even with increased scrutiny by the FTC, this uptick in M&A activity is good news for professional services, especially investment banks, law firms, HR agencies, and PR firms. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Varshali Bhattacharya, and this video is brought to you by the Economist Intelligence Unit in association with American Express.